Hey, it's Tim Patterson, Trade Show Guy, and I've been doing these weekly videos, and I kind of got inspired because last week I saw this exhibitor webinar on a lot of data that came down the pike on both the exhibitor side and the supplier side of how the industry is doing, and it wasn't a pretty picture. They had some hope that the things would, you know, turn to normal of some sort in 2021, but the rest of the year just doesn't look good. And it got me to thinking, I'm not going to share the data that's available here on their website online at Exhibitor Live. Is it exhibitoronline.com? I think that's it. Anyway, we'll put a link in the show notes, as it were. But, you know, it got me to thinking, what should exhibitors be doing at this point? Looking ahead to the rest of the year, planning ahead for 2021 and going forward. And I just kind of came up with this sort of shoot from the hip list. There's 10 things that I think exhibitors should do now. And believe me, this is certainly not a list written in stone, as it were. Some things may apply to you, some things may not. But I think it's all good to take a look at and decide, hey, maybe we should be doing this, maybe not. Number one, learn what show organizers are doing. You know, every show is a little different. The timeline's a little different. The size of the audience is different. The location is different. And some shows are planning in early 2021 to go digital or to be virtual. Others, you know, are kind of holding out hope that they can be live. So based on your schedule, you're just going to have to go through the list and say, okay, maybe we can do that one. Maybe we can do that one. Maybe we can't do that one. Number two, check into virtual shows. Look at the pros and cons. Sometimes shows are great virtual. Sometimes they are not. Depends on, I think, bottom line, how well it's executed and what kind of speakers they have and that sort of thing, how the exhibition hall is and all sorts of things. But, you know, some shows are going to be worthwhile and others are not. It's hard to know, really, frankly, until you get into them. But certainly worth a look, I think. Next thing, of course, is a lot of the virtual shows will offer you an exhibit hall which has some sort of virtual trade show exhibit. You can do your own probably better then, or you can hire someone to do a better one than they can probably do the show organizers, because they're just kind of doing a template or cut and paste and put your name in. But if you have someone design something custom for you, they've got various interactive things in there that you would probably not have in the other. But again, check out and learn about virtual trade show exhibits. Next, figure out what your budget is. I know a lot of companies are saying, you know, we had to cut our budget. We don't have as much for trade shows. Others are saying, you know, without having trade shows, we realize how valuable they are. And it all comes down to budget. So work with your management to help determine what the budget is for the next season, 2021. Go over timelines for the return of shows. Again, as I mentioned, some shows are coming back quickly. Others are not. It depends on where they are. Overseas shows might come back in Europe certainly better and quicker than in the States. So that's one thing to look at. What is the timeline? Next, determine what safety protocols you need from your standpoint, as an exhibitor standpoint, to put into place to make sure you're comfortable, your employees are comfortable, the anxiety level is low, as well as, you know, your visitors. And of course, the next thing is determine what safety protocols show organizers will put into place. And the I think the other question is, who's going to pay for it? Because adding all these social distancing measures and masks and cleaning and all that stuff, there's time involved, there's personnel involved. And I think that the show organizers are probably expecting the exhibitors to pay for a certain amount of it, and the exhibitors are probably expecting the show organizers to pay for a certain amount of it. There's going to be some give and take in that area. And so determine what the protocols are and how that is going to work. Next, of course, who's going to the shows? Again, every company has their own way of looking at this. Who's the best on the floor? Who's the most appropriate there? Sometimes those decisions are made regardless of the COVID-19 pandemic that is still affecting the trade show industry. But again, the COVID-19 might come into play. Who's got the most anxiety? Who's going to be okay with going to shows and interacting with people with masks on? So make personnel decisions based on that. Again, a couple of these things, or a lot of these things, can wait to the last minute, but some you need to really be thinking about now. Determine any exhibit revisions. I had some clients last year that were all planning to go to Expo West in March, early March, and like the day or two before the show, it got called off. But a lot of these exhibitors did a lot of prep to revise their exhibit. So will what they did then hold for the next time around, if in fact that happens, or not? Because they'll have new products to launch and life goes on, even though the trade show world is not right now. Learn what show organizers are doing. I got a couple of screenshots here. CES 2021 is all digital in January. Natural Products saying we're going to do it March 2 through 6th in Anaheim. So maybe that is subject to change. I don't know. Learn what show organizers are doing. Check with your contacts at those particular shows and check the website to make sure you're up to date. And understand the big picture as best you can. How does all of this work into your company-wide and your client-wide, your customer-wide look at the world? I mean, does this affect the way products go out, the way products are made, the way they're marketed? There's a bigger picture than just industry trade shows and your events you're going to, but that is a big part of it. But understand the biggest picture, the biggest look at it as best you can. This is Tim Patterson, and this is a little video that we like to do once a week. This is 10 things exhibitors should do now. You can find us at tradeshowguy.net.